Hello everyone, Cliff Dubenois here. Welcome to the Path to 1 Million. This is episode 21. Yes, this is a retake from yesterday because apparently the audio and the video quality were really bad. So this is a retake of yesterday. So I talked the other day about how if you're going to do something, it's always good to bring your level best. And I wanted to make sure that for this LinkedIn project that I've been working on, that I do bring my best. So I decided to go ahead and shoot a Facebook video that I can use for marketing purposes. I sent the video off to a few people to get some feedback, but also too, at the same point in time, I decided to post it to this private Facebook group that I belong to. I uploaded the video. I asked people for their feedback, and you know, I didn't care, you know, what they had to say about it, because I told them the same thing. I said, you know, I have no ego to bruise, so I'm much more concerned with being effective than I am with being right, so please provide any and all feedback. And the video sat up there for like 3 or 4 hours. Nobody said anything about it, and I didn't really anticipate a really huge reaction to the video. And then I noticed something when I was looking through the feed. Somebody had posted something a couple hours after I posted my video, talking about, man, I can't believe that there's somebody else doing something with this lead generation thing. And I read his post, and I got to admit, it kind of hurt. You know, it stung. Now, I didn't know if he was necessarily talking about me, but I just noticed that, you know, with it coming out a few hours after me, I was like, you know, there's probably some coincidence there. And I don't understand why people act that way or be negative or, you know, if, you know, whatever it is, everybody is, you know, completely different. But the one thing is that I was trying to figure out, you know, how do I handle this? How do I deal with this? Especially if I'm going to start getting out in front of a lot of people, you know, he's just one person, but if I start getting out there and trying to impact a million people, I'm going to have a lot of people that are going to try to tear me down. So I wasn't exactly sure how to handle that. And so, you know, you ask a question, the universe provides an answer. A couple days later, I was listening to a podcast of Tony Robbins, and he was interviewing Martine Rothblatt, and I hope I said that correctly. She's a billionaire. Now, if you've never heard of her before, that's okay. She graduated from UCLA with a degree in engineering. Then she went on to get her MBA from UCLA as well. And I'm not exactly sure how it happened, but one day she had a vision of radio being transmitted via satellite rather than radio towers. And so she did a bunch of calculations and ran some numbers and talked to a couple people. And of course, you know, everybody was telling her, oh, it can't be done and it'll never work. And every single time that they would give her some kind of a challenge, you know, or criticize her or something, she would always take that criticism and go in and answer that criticism. So an example of this would be when she went to the FTC to get licensing for this, they said, you know, we're not going to give it to you because if, you know, let's say that you're driving down a canyon, and there's leaves on trees, that it's going to block the signal from the satellite. So she's like, you know, she ran her numbers again and she's like, nope, that's not going to happen. So she actually piled the FTC people into her car and went out for a drive in some canyon somewhere where they couldn't see the tower that she had installed to beam the signal. And of course, you know, nobody, you know, there was no, you know, breakup in the signal or anything. So she was able to prove them wrong. But the thing is, every single time that they gave her some kind of a challenge, you know, like criticize her or whatever it was, she would always take that and go and make her product or her idea even stronger. And of course, you know, like one of the things that also came up too, is they said, you know, your satellite's too big, it won't fit on a rocket. And so she said, that's true for US manufacturers. So she started looking over in Europe. And, you know, wouldn't you know it, she happened to find a rocket manufacturer in Europe who was building a big enough rocket to launch her satellite into orbit. So, you know, there's another problem solved. But, you know, anyways, Martine was actually the one that gave birth to Sirius XM Radio. And, of course, now that's, you know, valued at a $6 billion company. Good for her. But, you know, and then after that, she come to find out her daughter was diagnosed with some rare disease that affects the blood vessels, only the blood vessels between the heart and the lungs. and people with this disease only have like 3 to 5 year lifespan. There's no medication, there's no treatment on the market for it at all. So she completely stepped back from SiriusXM radio and decided to start learning about medicine, medication, and the health conditions. And she stumbled across some company that held a patent on a drug that didn't work. However, one of the side effects was that it would impact the blood vessels between the heart and the lungs, you know, the very thing that her daughter was suffering from. So she tried to get a license and a patent from the company. Of course, they wouldn't let her do it because, well, you're not a doctor and you really don't understand medicine and they always told her no. So she went out and hired the doctor. She went out and hired the technicians. She went out and got the biochemist, everybody that she needed to overcome every one of their objections and make her business stronger. And finally they agreed. And now because of, you know, her getting access to this medicine and her daughter's been taking it, her daughter has lived for 20 years. And, you know, just because she took all this criticism that people were giving her and, you know, turned it into something else. And, you know, and it was amazing that, you know, during this interview, because Tony Robbins even asked her, he was like, man, how do you keep going, you know, in the face of all of this criticism that you're doing it? And not only do you take that criticism, but you thrive off of it. And she said something that really struck me. She said, you know, she says, critics are actually your best friends. The reason why is because they're usually going to point something out to you that you completely missed. But their whole thing is that they use it to take you down, but you only go down if you let yourself go down. So when somebody criticizes her for one of her ideas and they tell her that it's not going to work and they give a reason why, she's like, okay. And she answers that challenge, answers that question, and moves on to the next one. So with regards to this guy on Facebook and the critique and the criticism that he gave me, you know, I just decided, you know what, I'm going to take another pass at this video. I'm going to make the script even stronger. I'm going to rehearse even more. I'm going to get it in a better setting. You know, I'm just going to improve the quality of it overall. And, you know, the good news is I still have the script memorized up here, but, you know, I'll be able to just go and make it better. And so next week when the site launches, I'll just have that much stronger of an ad. So anyways, I just wanted to share that little lesson with you, something that I observed. Once again, I'm really sorry about the quality of the video and the audio from yesterday, but I will be back tomorrow with another episode of The Path to 1 Million. I will see you then.